To deal with the mutual exclusion problem, Pthread supports mutexes. As we explained when discussing Birrell's paper, mutexes provide a mechanism to solve the mutual exclusion problems among concurrent threads. Mutual exclusion lets us ensure that threads access shared state in a controlled manner so that only one thread at a time can perform modifications or otherwise access that shared variable. Birrell proposed the use of the mutex itself and an operation to lock mutexes. In pthreads, the mutex data structure is represented via type pthread mutex type. For the lock operation, remember that Birrell used the block construct where the critical section was protected by these curly brackets, where the open curly bracket meant that the mutex was being locked, and the closed curly bracket meant that the mutex was unlocked or freed. In pthreads, this concept is supported explicitly. There is a separate pthread mutex lock operation and a separate pthread mutex unlock operation. Whatever code appears between these two statements will correspond to the critical section. As an example, remember that in the thread introductory lecture, we implemented the save insert operation using Birrell's construct in the following way. With pthreads, the same save insert operation would be implemented as follows. We would explicitly be locking and unlocking the mutex around the insert operation in the shared list mylist, and also note that the mutex is of appropriate type, pthread mutex type. Pthread supports a number of other mutex-related operations. Several of them are worth highlighting. First, mutexes must be explicitly initialized. This operation allocates a mutex data structure and also specifies its behavior. It takes as an argument a mutex attribute variable, and this is how we specify the mutex behavior. By passing null as this argument, we have an option to specify the default behavior for mutexes, or we can set one or more attributes that are associated with mutexes. For instance, pthreads permits mutexes and condition variables in general to be shared among processes. The default behavior would make a mutex private to a process, so only visible among the threads within a process, whereas we can explicitly modify that behavior and make sure that the mutex can be shared with other processes. Another interesting operation is pthread mutex trilock. Unlike the lock operation, which will block the calling thread if the mutex is in use, what trilock will end up doing is it will check the mutex, and if it is in use, it will actually return immediately and it will notify the calling thread that the mutex is not available. If the mutex is free, trilock will result in the mutex successfully being locked. But if the mutex is locked, trilock will not block the calling thread. This gives the calling thread an option to go and do something else and perhaps come back a little bit later to check if the mutex is free. Also, you should make sure that you free up any pthread-related data structures, and for mutexes, for instance, you have the mutex destroy operation. These are just some of the operations pthread supports for mutexes. The ones we described here are enough to get you started with pthreads, and you can always refer to the pthreads documentation for information on the others. In the previous lesson, we mentioned a number of common pitfalls when it comes to writing multithreaded programs. Few that are worth mentioning in the context of pthread mutexes include the following. Shared data should always be accessed through a single mutex. This is such a frequent error that it's worth reiterating. Next, the mutex scope must be visible to all threads. Remember, a mutex cannot be defined as a private variable to a single thread, including main. You must declare all of your mutexes as global variables. Another important tip is to globally order the locks. Once we establish an order between the locks, basically between the mutexes in the pthreads program, then for all threads, we have to make sure that the mutexes are locked in that particular order. Remember, we said that this is a way to ensure that deadlocks don't happen. Finally, remember to always unlock a mutex. Moreover, make sure that you always unlock the correct mutex. Given that pthreads has separate lock and unlock operations, it can be easy to forget the unlock, and compilers will not necessarily tell you that there is a problem with your code. So you have to make sure that you keep track of your locks and unlocks.